Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at Petya, the ransomware that made headlines this morning as it rapidly spread across the world. This ransomware only intentionally spreads on internal networks, unlike WannaCry, which attempted to spread to any random network it could find using the Eternal Blue exploit developed by the NSA. Petya still uses the Eternal Blue exploit, but if that doesn't work to infect new PCs, it uses further exploits to dump credentials on an infected machine and tries to run itself on other computers on the network with PSExec. So, even if your network has been patched against WannaCry and the Eternal Blue exploit, it's still completely possible to be infected by this ransomware if it infiltrates your network. Now, I am not on a network. I have totally disconnected this virtual machine because I want to attempt to minimize the risk to other machines on my network. This part's going to go pretty quick, but we'll run this dropper which will infect our PC, search for more computers to infect, and ultimately crash the system so a new bootloader can take hold and encrypt your drive. So let's run it. Alright, we want to make changes? You bet we do. Yes, let's go. So, searches for more computers to infect, and it won't be able to find any since we're not on an actual network. And then it crashes our machine with a blue screen. Transport determined that the remote system is down. So I have turned off the option to automatically restart after a system crash. And because of this, at this point, it is still completely possible to recover your PC. If you boot from a live CD, you can recover all of your data because it has not yet been encrypted. But when the computer restarts after this screen, it'll present a fake check disk, and while that's running, it's actually encrypting your master file table. If you turn off your PC while this scan disk runs, then you can recover your data, but that's no fun, so we're just gonna let it go to completion. Let's go ahead and restart. So we've gone ahead and reset here. So here we go, it's repairing the file system. Do not turn off your PC. If you abort this process, you could destroy all of your data. Please ensure that your power cable is plugged in. So here goes check disk. And as soon as this is finished, we get this nice flashing badass skull. It says press any key. Something's telling me that wasn't a real check disk. So we're going to press enter. We see you have became, oh no, you became victim of the Petya ransomware. The hard disks of your computer have been encrypted with a military-grade encryption algorithm. There is no way to restore your data without a special key. You can purchase this key on the darknet page shown in step 2. Purchase your key and restore your data. Please follow these 3 easy steps. So this is actually a slightly different variant from others seen on the internet, which requests you to actually email an email address with your decryption key. And the problem with that is that the email address went down very quickly after this ransomware launched, meaning it was completely impossible to decrypt your computer after it was infected. Of course, we don't have a key, so anything we type is an incorrect key, and we can't really get through this to get back to our computer. You can attempt to recover the master boot record, but your master file table will still be encrypted. I've also seen reports about a decryption tool, but I haven't been able to look into those too much tonight. So if they work, maybe I'll give it a try and make an updated video on this. But for now, that is about it for the Petya ransomware. Thank you for watching. Take care.